Hey everybody, welcome back to Mile a Minute Vlog. I'm Chris. So it's 2014, and last year and years before then, I like to keep track of all the movies I've seen, the new movies I've seen. And last year, I saw about 53 different films. Of those 53 new films that I saw, 41 of them were new films. Basically, they came out in 2013. For me, with my busy schedule, that's a lot of movies. That's about 10 short of a movie a week. Now, a little heads up before I start this list. These are movies that I really enjoyed this year. They're not exactly Academy Award-winning films. I still intend on seeing like 12 Years a Slave, Blue Jasmine, Nebraska, Inside Llewyn Davis, but these movies are personally my favorite. Basically, I could go back and rewatch these a lot. Number 10 is a time travel flick. I know there's a surprise there. It's called About Time. It's a Richard Curtis movie, the same guy that brought us Love Actually. It stars Rachel McAdams and Billy Weasley from the Harry Potter movies. Yes, he actually has a starring role. Basically, this movie is about a guy who the men in his family have the ability to time travel. He uses the ability of time travel to basically fall in love with Rachel McAdams, and it's about the little things that can go wrong with time travel. I don't want to spoil any more for you, but it is a great movie. Check it out. It's going to be out on Blu-ray on February 4th. Number 9 is probably one of the most outrageous movies I saw this year. The Wolf on Wall Street. This is another team-up between Marty Scorsese and Leo DiCaprio, and with a little bit of Jonah Hill on the side. This movie is insane from the beginning to the end. It basically shows the craziness and corruption that happens in Wall Street. This movie is based on the autobiography of Jordan Belfort, which is the character that Leo DiCaprio plays in the movie. It covers basically from when he started his time on Wall Street as a little small person working for a small company to being probably one of the biggest people in Wall Street and probably one of the most corrupt too. Wolf on Wall Street is in theaters right now, so go out and find it. Just a heads up though, it is rated R for a reason. Actually, it almost got an NC-17, so caution when you go see this movie. Number 8 is also on my summer must-see list. And it's Elysium, Neil Blomkamp's sophomore effort. It stars Matt Damon and Jodie Foster, and it's kind of a sci-fi futuristic look on the take between the poor versus the 1%. It's already out on Blu-ray and DVD, so you should check it out. Rent it, go to Redbox, go to your local video store, check it out, it's really good. Number 7, one of the best thrillers on this list, Captain Phillips. This is a Paul Greengrass movie based on the real-life story of Captain Phillips. A cargo ship captain, played by Tom Hanks, whose cargo ship is taken over by Somali pirates. This is probably Tom Hanks' best performance of the year. Saving Mr. Banks was pretty good, but him as Walt Disney can't even hold a candle to him as Captain Phillips in this movie. Captain Phillips will be out on Blu-ray and DVD January 21st. Number 6 on this list, I have talked about a lot. In fact, I did a review about this already. Unfortunately, I don't have a beer this time, but you can click on it. It's right over here. It's World's End, the final film of the Coronado trilogy by Edgar Wright, Nick Frost, and Simon Pegg. Okay, so you don't want to click over here to watch the review? Let me give you a quick synopsis. A bunch of friends try to complete a failed pub crawl that they did when they were younger, and in the process of them doing that, aliens take over the city. That's all I'm going to give you. Check it out. If you like Shaun of the Dead, if you like Hot Fuzz, check it out. Complete the trilogy. Oh, and it's already out on Blu-ray and DVD. Number 5 is Monsters vs. Robots. It's Guillermo del Toro's Pacific Rim. Sure, it's your big budget sci-fi action movie summer blockbuster, but I just can watch this movie over and over again. It makes me want to pilot a Jaeger. Not a Jaeger bomb, not a drink, a Jaeger. That's what they call those giant robots that fight the monsters. If you're a fan of Guillermo del Toro's work, check it out. Also, if you're a fan of anime, check it out too, because it has a lot of the same kind of cliches and styles that you can find in a lot of anime. You can find it on Blu-ray and DVD. Number 4, surprisingly again, this is off my summer movie list because summer was such an awesome time for movies this year. It's J.J. Abrams' sequel to Star Trek, Star Trek in the Darkness. No pun intended, but this is the Empire Strikes Back of the new Star Trek series. It's a lot darker, it's a lot creepier, and there's a lot more plot twists. Not to mention you got Benedict Cumberbatch in there being a pretty much badass villain. J.J. Abrams once again adds to the giant mythos that is Star Trek in his little reboot and just makes it for an awesome thrill ride. By the way, it's on Blu-ray and DVD. Check it out. Number three on this list is from the director that brought us Where the Wild Things Are, adaptation, Being John Malkovich, it's Spike Jonze's Her. Now, this is only the second movie that he has written and directed, but it is freaking fantastic. It takes place in the not-too-distant future, where Joaquin Phoenix pretty much falls in love with his OS, or his phone, so to speak. His phone, voiced by Scarlett Johansson. Who wouldn't fall in love with that voice? It's basically a modern love story, and I use the word modern as it's a computer and a human in love, but it's definitely worth checking out. I highly recommend it. And Joaquin Phoenix, heck, even Scarlett Johansson deserve Oscar nominations for their performances. I know Scarlett Johansson is just a voice in this movie, but the emotion expressed just in her voice is definitely Oscar worthy. It's currently in theater, so go check it out. Number two is my number one favorite movie of the summer, and that is The Man of Steel. I know this is a surprise to you. Me, a Superman fan, has The Man of Steel as his number two movie of the year. There's so much I could say about this movie, but it would take too long and it'd be a really long video. But this is the Superman movie that I have been waiting for. This is Superman. This is how Superman is supposed to be. Supposed to be fighting, throwing punches, dealing with, you know, outer space evils, not spinning the world back around to reverse time. Zack Snyder, Henry Cavill, Amy Adams, they all did a fantastic job in this, and I can't wait to see what they do with Batman and Superman and even maybe the Justice League series. You can find Man of Steel out on Blu-ray and DVD. My number one movie is probably not a surprise if you've watched most of my reviews and videos on here. It's Gravity by Alfonso Cuarón. Now, I've already done a review, and it's right up over here. You can click right over there to watch it. Watching this movie in theaters was an experience. It wasn't just watching something and just taking it in. I felt like I was in space watching this, and it's a must-see in 3D. Now, I know you won't see it in 3D when it's out on Blu-ray and DVD, but it is coming back out to theaters for the Oscar runs. So if you get a chance, check it out. It's fantastic. If you want more information about it, click on my review right over here. Question of the day. I want to know, what was your favorite movie of 2013? Put it in the comments below. Also, don't forget, you can follow us on Twitter at this address on the screen. We'll have news and updates when our videos come out. Also, don't forget to follow us on Twitter, because for later videos, we are going to be starting a contest surrounded by the Oscars, and it will require you following us on Twitter, so don't forget to do that. As usual, don't forget to like and subscribe to this video. You can click on the like button right down there. That'll like this video, and it'll let us know, hey, you like this video? We'll make more of them. Subscribing adds us to your YouTube feed, so whenever you log into YouTube, we'll show up in your news feed. For the Mild Mannered Vlog, I'm Chris. Golden Globes are freaking insane. Brooklyn Nine-Nine winning Best Comedy? Look at me, look at me. I'm the captain now. Also, apparently in the future, we all become hipsters and wear high-waisted pants.